Russia and Ukraine have carried out a dramatic prisoner exchange that's being hailed as a significant step toward easing tensions between the two countries. It's the biggest exchange since the start of the Crimea conflict and includes the release of 24 Ukrainian soldiers taken captive by Russia last year. There was controversy, however, over the release of a separatist commander thought to have been involved in the downing of Malaysia Airlines flight MH17.
35 Ukrainian men held prisoners in Russia touched down on home soil. These are the men part of a much-anticipated prisoner swap with Russia, including high-profile detainees like filmmaker Oleg Sentsov and 24 sailors who were captured in the Black Sea late last year.
We can't understand that this has already happened.
The sailors had been charged with entering Russian waters near the Crimean Peninsula, which Russian troops seized and annexed from Ukraine in 2014. In the 5 years since, the Russian-backed rebel uprising has seen 13,000 people killed. The swap is being seen as a beacon of hope in bringing peace to the region, opening the door for meaningful talks between the two countries.
We have to do all the steps to finish this horrible war.
This is a new chapter in relations between Russia and Ukraine.
I think this is the first chapter.
Both the Ukrainian and the Russian president said to have made concessions in the name of goodwill.
The spirit in which this exchange has been done is different and it's much more positive. There's much more straight talk.
But despite similar scenes in Russia, not all concessions are being celebrated. Russia insisted on the return of this man in white, Volodymyr Semak. He had been the only person held in jail in connection to the shooting down of Malaysian Airlines flight MH17, killing all 298 people on board, including 38 Australians. His release a major blow to those closest to the victims, like Jack Medcraft, whose friends Albert and Marie Risk died.
I think it's very frustrating, it's very disappointing, and it just goes to show that lives really don't matter when it comes to political decisions.
But international reaction to the prisoner swap remains overwhelmingly positive. The US president tweeted that it was perhaps a first giant step to peace, while the German chancellor said it was a sign of hope. Given the country's troubled history, there is an air of cautious optimism. The next crucial step, an upcoming summit between Ukraine, Russia, France and Germany to discuss resolving the conflict. Amelia Dunn, SBS World News.